Good morning, students. So in the previous video we learned how to find the zeros of a quadratic polynomial, and also given the zeros of a quadratic polynomial, how to find the quadratic polynomial. So if alpha and beta are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial ax squared plus bx plus c, then the quadratic polynomial ax squared plus bx plus c is given by the formula, can be obtained by using k into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. What? Ax square plus bx plus c should be in the form of k into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. If alpha and beta are the zeros, then the required quadratic polynomial is there. But now, so given the zeros of a quadratic polynomial, now, take for example, let 3n minus 1 be the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. How do you find the quadratic polynomial? First of all, we assume this 3 as alpha or minus 1 as alpha and beta as minus 1. First, we find alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta. Nothing but what? If alpha and beta are the zeros, alpha plus beta represent what? Sum of the zeros. That is equal to what? 2. Alpha into beta, which is nothing but product of the zeros. Product of the zeros. 3 into minus 1. That is equal to minus 3. And ax square plus bx plus c be the required quadratic polynomial. And alpha and beta, these zeros, by assuming these zeros as alpha and beta, and by joining alpha plus beta means sum of the zeros. So, but they give alpha and beta. We find alpha plus beta and alpha beta. And we use the formula k into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Now, k into x square minus half. What is alpha plus beta obtained here? 2. And what is alpha beta obtained here? Minus 3. Now, k into x square minus 2x minus 3. Here we don't find any rational coefficients. These are all integral coefficients. So then we put k equal to 1. When k equal to 1, what is the quadratic polynomial obtained? X square minus 2x minus 3. So x square minus 2x minus 3. 1 and this one gives what? X square minus 2x minus 3. Now the required quadratic polynomial that the zeros are 3 and minus 1 is what? X square minus 2x minus 3. But now, in the next problem, given alpha and beta zeros, we can find the quadratic polynomial by using the formula k into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Given sum of the zeros and product of the zeros directly without giving the zeros. So here we don't give the zeros now. We give alpha plus beta. We did not find alpha and beta. We did not find these zeros. Alpha plus beta is given. There is a quadratic polynomial whose sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta, equal to 5. And whose product of the zeros, alpha into beta, equal to 6. Can you find quadratic polynomial? When the zeros are given, by assuming those zeros are alpha and beta, and by finding alpha plus beta and alpha beta, we use that formula. But already alpha plus beta and alpha beta is are given. No need to find the zeros. No need to have the zeros, alpha and beta. You can use directly. So let the given quadratic polynomial, whose sum of the zeros is 5 and product of the zeros is 6, be A star plus B plus C. So, and its zeros are alpha and beta. And its zeros are what? Alpha and beta. Now, what is the required quadratic polynomial? K into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. When alpha and beta are given, first we find alpha plus beta and alpha beta. But here alpha plus beta and alpha beta are given. Directly they give sum of the zeros and the product of zeros. Then you put alpha plus beta, you replace alpha plus beta by 5 and alpha beta by 6. k into x square minus 5x plus 6. K into x square minus 5x plus 6. Now here we have integral coefficients. So you can put k equal to 1. Put k equal to 1. When k equal to 1, what is the resultant polynomial? X square minus 5x plus 6. That is the resultant polynomial. Now you go to 3.3. 3.3 page 67 problem 2. What is the problem given? Find the quadratic polynomial in each case. Find the quadratic polynomial in each case with the given numbers, with the given numbers as the sum and product of the zeros respectively. So what is the question? Find the quadratic polynomial in each case. So we have here six cases, six problems with the given number. So in each problem we have two numbers as the sum and product of the zeros respectively. Here, in the first problem, we have 1 by 4 and minus 1. Now, you have to assume the first number as the sum of the zeros. And minus 1 as the product of the zeros. But in the previous problem, that is the third problem, 3.3, third problem, what are given there? Zeros are given. And we assume those zeros as alpha and beta. And we use the formula. But here what are given? Sum of the zeros and also product of the zeros. See, let the quadratic, then let the required quadratic polynomial be ax square plus bh plus c and alpha and beta beats zeros. So let the required quadratic polynomial whose sum of the zeros is 1 by 4 and product of the zeros is minus 1 is ax square plus bx plus c. And let the zeros of this ax square plus bx plus c be what? Alpha and beta. So now here 1 by 4 is what? Sum of the zeros. As we have assumed that alpha and beta are the zeros, sum of the zeros is denoted by alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta given here? 1 by 4. In the previous case, two numbers are there in each case and they are nothing but alpha and beta, zeros. But here, sum of the zeros and product of the zeros. Now, product of the zeros, alpha into beta, what is that? Minus 1. Now, so now what is the required quadratic polynomial? K into x square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Here alpha plus beta is given directly. What is that? 1 by 4. K into x square minus half 1 by 4 into x plus what is alpha into beta? Minus 1. K into x square minus 1 by 4 into x, x by 4 plus into minus minus 1. So to make the coefficients as integral, integers, or to avoid rational coefficient, we to eliminate this 4, we put k equal to 4. Put k equal to 4. put k equal to 4 in this one. 4 into x square minus x by 4 minus 1. Multiply each term by 4. 4 into x square, 4x square. 4 into 1 by 4. 4 into x by 4 minus x. 4 into minus 1 equal to 1. Minus 4. So this is the required quadratic polynomial. See, here there are two numbers given in each case. In the first one, there are 1 by 4 and minus 1, where 1 by 4 is the sum of the zeros. They are not zeros. Sum of the zeros. And this one, product of the zeros. So the required quadratic polynomial will be 2 sum of the zeros is 1 by 4 and product of the zeros minus 1 be x star of the x plus a. And if zeros be denoted by alpha and beta, as sum of the zeros is given as 1 by 4, we denote the same by alpha plus beta. Because alpha plus beta represents sum of the zeros. Alpha into beta represents product of the zeros, which is equal to minus 1. Now, what is the required quadratic polynomial? So, k into x square minus half alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. K into x square minus half alpha plus beta equal to what? 1 by 4 into x plus alpha beta minus 1. K into x square minus x by 4 minus 1. Put k equal to 4. To avoid getting rational coefficients, we put k equal to 4. 4 into x square minus x by 4 minus 1. 4x square minus x minus 4. This is the required quadratic polynomial whose sum of the zeros is 1 by 4 and product of the zeros is minus 1. Now I take the second one. Root 2 and 1 by 3. Root 2 and 1 by 3. Let the required quadratic polynomial be x square plus bx plus c and alpha and beta to the 0. Sum of the zeros. Here, this first number represents sum of the zeros, whereas the second number represents product of the zeros. Second problem is, okay? In the second one, here, second problem, sum of the zeros is root 2 and product of the zeros is 1 by 3. So, it is root 2 and it is 1 by 3. Now, what is the formula? K into the beta quadratic polynomial whose sum of the zeros and product of the zeros is given as k into x square minus half alpha plus beta and x plus alpha beta. K into x square minus alpha plus beta. What is alpha plus beta? Root 2. Plus what is alpha beta? 1 by 3. K into x square minus root 2x plus 1 by 3. So, the avoided rational coefficient, yet the denominator is what here? 3. Put k equal to 3. Put k equal to 3. 3 into x square minus root 2x plus 1 by 3. 3x square. 3 into root 2x. 3 root 2x. 3 into 1 by 3, that's 1. This is the required quadratic polynomial whose sum of the zeros is root 2 and product of the zeros is 1 by 3. Now the third one, 0 root 5. Here, third one, given the numbers are 0 and root 5. What are those numbers? 0 is what here? Sum of the zeros. Root 5 is? Product of zero, both of the question. So I will read the question once again. Find the quadratic polynomial in each case with the given number as the sum and product of the zeros respectively. So in each case we have two numbers. And the first number represents sum of the zeros, the second number represents product of the zero. Here, and the same steps. Sum of the zeros equal to alpha plus beta equal to what? 0. Product of the zeros equal to alpha into beta equal to root 5. Now, formula is same. K into x square minus half. We have to put alpha plus beta equal to what? 0. Alpha beta root 5. K into x square plus root 5. So, 0 into x, 0. Now, here we have k equal to 1. Put k equal to 1. So 1 into x square plus root 15. X square plus root 15 is the required part of polynomial whose sum of the zeros is 0 and product of zeros is root 15. Now the next one. Here sum of the zeros is 1, product of zeros is 1. So alpha plus beta 1, alpha into beta 1, k into x square minus of 1 into x, this is alpha plus beta 1, plus alpha beta 1, k into x square minus x plus 1. So we put k equal to 1. 1 into x square minus x plus 1. X square minus x plus 1. That is the required part of polynomial. Okay. Now the fifth one. Minus 1 by 4, 1 by 4. What? Minus 1 by 4, 1 by 4. Here, so sum of the zeros alpha plus beta equal to minus 1 by 4. Product of zeros alpha into beta equal to 1 by 4. K into x square minus half. Replace alpha plus beta by minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4 into x plus 1 by 4. K into x square plus minus into minus plus 1 into x, x by 4 plus 1 by 4. So we eliminate this 4 now. By putting k equal to 4. Actually, we put different values for k, but we put k equal to 4 here. 4x square, 4 into x square plus x by 4 plus 1 by 4. 4x square plus x plus 1. This is the required quadratic problem. And the last one is 4 and 1. 4 and 1. 4, 1. That is 6th one. Sum of the zeros, 4. Product of zeros, 1. Now the required part of the problem is k into x square minus of alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. K into x square minus of 4x plus 1. K into here, k into x square minus 4x plus 1. We put k equal to 1. This one is the required quadratic polynomial. Whose sum of the zeros is 4 and product of the zeros is 1. So far we have discussed about the how to find the zeros of a quadratic polynomial. And also, we verified the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. And we derived the format to find the sum of the zeros of a quadratic polynomial. That is not minus b by a. And the product of the zeros of the quadratic polynomial, that is c by a. And also, we learned how to find the quadratic polynomial when the zeros are given. And also when sum of the zeros and the product of the zeros are given. Now, we are going to find the zeros of cubic polynomials in some of the cases. Now go through page number 57. Try this. Find the zeros of the polynomials given below. Number 1, minus x cube. See, to find the zero of this cubic polynomial minus x cube, we have to equate this minus x cube to 0. Multiply both sides by minus 1. you get x cube equal to minus 180. When x cube equal to 0, then what is the value of x? Cube root 0. That is equal to 0. So 0 is the 0 of the polynomial minus x cube. Now, second one. Find the 0 of the cubic polynomial x square minus x cube. To find the 0 of this cubic polynomial, we have to equate the cubic polynomial to 0. So here from this you can take, you can factorize this x square minus x cube. By taking x square as common, we get x square into x cube. So x square into 1 minus x equal to 0. We have to equate each factor to 0. X square equal to 0, 1 minus x equal to 0. When x square equal to 0, then what is the value of x? Root 0, that is 0. Then 1 minus x equal to 0, minus x equal to minus 1, x equal to 1. So what are the zeros of this x square minus x cube? 0 and 1 are the zeros. Here, what is the 0? 0 is the 0 of minus x cube. Now the third one. So find the zeros of x cube minus 5x square plus 6x. Find the zero of this cubic polynomial x cube minus 5x square plus 6x. You have to equate the polynomial to 0. Can you take anything as common from these three terms? See, you can take x as common. X into x square minus 5x plus 6. X into x square x cube, x into minus 5x square, x into 6, 6x. Equal to 0. You have to equate each factor to 0. X equal to 0, x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. So it is quadratic polynomial. And you know how to find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. So here, 1, 6, 6. So select the numbers whose product is 6 and whose sum equal to 5. 3, 2, 6, 3 plus 2, 5. So we write x square minus 3x minus 2x plus 6 equal to 0. From these two, we can take x as common. X into x minus 3 minus 2 into x minus 3 equal to 0. X minus 3 into x minus 2 equal to 0. So you have the equity factor to 0. X minus 3 equal to 0, x minus 2 equal to 0. X equal to 3, x equal to 2. So all we have x equal to 0 here. So 0, 3 and 2 are the zeros of the given cubic polynomial x cube minus 5x star plus 6x. So thank you. In the coming video, we are going to find the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients of a cubic polynomial.